flesh and bones scattered along the borders of our country does not make us a gated community. Like Gandhi, wipe the tears and smile for the children. Don't tell a soul that we run into the arms of poverty. I may be a poor Somali, but I'm still somebody. I'm tired of seeing bodies, hearts having their last hiccups, the blood and veins running their last mile. I don't want to believe a lie, but this is because our bones are thick and our skin contains the melanin of color. You were supposed to be my sisters and brothers. The civil war in Somalia is like the human body deteriorating from mistaking itself for a disease. We are the white blood cells eating at our country from the inside out, destroying the unit. It's significant for the world to get into it, and I never deny home being where the hatred is, but I don't like this penitentiary. Apparently, sleepless nights on frigid floors and the bulging bellies of my offspring are felonies. And I know you people, you Americans, you walk into these museums and ooh and ah at the bones of display that are probably the remnants of my grandfather. Or necklace, but please handle it gently. They come from the jaws of my baby sister. These bones are the result of your ignorance, and to make a change, a reflection of your unwillingness. Drop to your knees and beg for forgiveness. Time is running out, but I can still hear the cries behind my shoulders and beneath my feet. Don't be fooled. The flesh and bones scattered along the borders of our country does not make us a gated community. These run down my guts, don't mean we live like Gandhi. This poverty is involuntary. Time has run out, but I will forever hear the cries behind my shoulders and beneath my fatal feet.